MSI Afterburner is an overclocking tool created by MSI, but it can be used for mostly all of the NVIDIA graphics cards and AMD graphics cards. You'll notice that when you see the first screen, it presents a monitor that shows the clock speed of your GPU and the clock speed of the memory, other items such as the voltage and the temperature. It also gives you ways to set the core and memory clock overclocks and save them under profiles. For my Dell Alienware M15R4, you notice that some of the options are grayed out, which it's probably blocked by Dell, but I still have access to both the memory and the GPU. I have a setting of plus 1000 on the memory and plus 135 on the GPU. And this will give us more horsepower when running intensive games. Another feature that you'll want to go to is under settings. And this gives us various checkboxes. For example, if you want MSI to load with Windows, you'll probably want to check that. And if you want to be able to unlock voltages, if you have a desktop discrete GPU, then it'll allow you to tweak some of the voltage settings there. On the monitoring tab, it'll show some information on here that can be used for when you're putting it on screen display. You'll notice that the various different types of monitoring that's going on using this tool. When you go into the on-screen display, that's where you can have the special keys that can toggle it on and off. On the benchmark tab, you can use this to benchmark the speed of some of the games that you're playing. For screen capture, if you want to take a screenshot and have it saved somewhere on a certain file format, MSI allows you to do that as well. MSI Afterburner also has a video capture capability where you can take various clips of whatever games you have, and you can couple that with the on-screen display. It's very variable when presenting benchmarks. On the profile tab, you'll notice that here's the areas where the various profiles can be named so that you can use it when you pull it up. You'll also notice on the main dashboard. Lastly, we have the user interface, which is very useful when you want to give your MSI Afterburner a different skin. So you notice I chose the Windows 11 one, but there are various other ones that are available as well. If I went here and I put it as default, then you'll notice that some of the screens will look different when you apply the skin. That's a good one if you have an NVIDIA card. One other option that's missing here is if you have a desktop GPU, MSI Afterburner will allow you to control the fan speeds and fan curves of your GPU. On this laptop, it's controlled by the Dell Alienware program, so I don't have direct access to that. But if you do have a discrete desktop GPU, it'll allow you to check when the fans can come on based on temperature, which is a very useful item to have as well for overclocking. And thank you. That's it for MSI Afterburner.